This is Lorin Parker for Expert Village, and we're talking about etching a circuit board, and I'm going to talk specifically now about this laser jet transfer method. I've printed out this circuit board artwork. I can't remember what this design is for. I used it at one point for a prototype. It's designed on a computer. You can find lots of different circuit board designs online and kits that you can make your own circuit boards for and circuits that you can make your own circuit boards for. You print this out, and you print it out on a laser jet printer, and we're going to remelt this with an iron and melt the toner back onto copper rather than this blue paper. This is an intermediate. And so it's kind of like those iron-on t-shirts that we used to have. So the goal with this is the press and peel stuff works best at about 275 to 325 degrees. So I'm just measuring it with a temperature probe, and it takes a little while for the temperature probe to get up there. On my iron, that's usually on the linen setting. It's usually one of the higher settings on the iron. On some irons, like a real nifty professional iron, it's going to be a much lower setting. The best way to tell is to put a thermometer on it or a temperature sensor. I know that not everybody has one, so then the second best thing is to just feel it out. You can definitely tell if it's too hot because you're going to burn the paper, and it's looking like we're at about 280 some, starting to slow down. So we're well within range, probably between 275 and 325. So I'm about there. So what I want to do now is I've designed this circuit board in a program called Eagle Light, which is a free program out of Germany you can get off the internet. And now I'm just going to take a little bit of masking tape and I'm going to tape it down to the surface of the copper. And I'll just kind of wrap that around there. And I just want to make sure that this doesn't move at all when I'm running the iron over it. And it's okay to get masking tape on top of the area that's going to be transferred because it's the heat doing the work and the heat will go through the masking tape and into the copper. And so I kind of want to get this, and I've got a little bit bubbled up, so I'm just going to make sure that I can flatten it out again, get it nice and flat, press it down really good there, and maybe just put one more. It's bubbling up a little bit here. You want it just to be really taut. Okay, so I've finished taping this down and it's pretty tight. One trick though is that I want to leave one side up just a little bit so that I can pull it up, because what I'm going to do is, one trick I've developed is I start at one corner and just lift it up to see if it's transferring over and then put it back down and do the rest. That prevents me from ruining the whole thing on the first pass. So I've got it taped down tight, but I can also just peel it a little bit just to test it. And that looks good to me.